Greetings, Eric Bakker. How are you all going out there? Thanks for coming back and checking out my video. I often get asked about gluten and candida. Eric, can I eat gluten if I've got candida? Can I eat bread? Can I have waffles? Can I have this? Can I have that? So many people have jumped on the gluten-free bandwagon these days. Many people. I can remember discussing gluten-free with people back in the 80s when it was still quite a foreign concept. And I had an idea that some people were gluten intolerant. But today, it seems to be like everybody's gluten intolerant. And you can even buy gluten-free toilet paper, for goodness sakes. Isn't that crazy? So, what's the connection between candida and gluten? Is there a link between them both? Well, there's a big link between them both. So let's start talking about this protein called HWP1, or hyphal wall protein 1. I'll put some links in the description box below so you can click on it and read a bit about it on Wikipedia and other studies that have been conducted on this particular protein. So this isn't hocus pocus or mumbo jumbo. This is actual science, okay? So it turns out that this HWP1 protein is very interesting. Candida creates this protein so it can hook up to the intestinal wall. It makes this protein, and it allows this protein allows it to attach to parts of the digestive tract. The immune system doesn't recognize it very much as foreign at all. It doesn't recognize the candida. And the reason why is because the protein or the amino acid configuration of HWP1 is very similar to the amino acid configuration of two particular type of proteins found in gluten called gliadin proteins. There are about seven different proteins that make up gluten, but alpha gliadin and gamma gliadin very much look like HWP1 protein. So the immune system comes along and it sees these proteins, gluten, and it sees these proteins, HWP1, and it seems to think that they're all good buddies up there having a good time in the gut. So it tends to ignore this thing. But candida is not, the HWP1 protein is not very stable because candida has got a limited life cycle. So it will live and it will die and it will send out spores and hyphenate and create more candida and more candida eventually, you know, over time, depending on the balance of the good bacteria and other bacteria in the gut. So eventually, as candida dies, it leaves the HWP1 protein or the shell of it behind. Now, of course, this starts to slowly change, which is often confuses the immune system because it's not a very stable protein unless candida is alive. So as the protein starts to denature and change of candida, you know, the shell of candida, the immune system will start to recognize it now as foreign and initiate or mount a response or an attack on that protein. But it gets very confused because now it's starting to think that the gliadin proteins are the candida proteins, so it starts attacking those as well. And this sets up what we call autoimmunity, an autoimmune reaction, right? So it's interesting, very interesting concept, but I've seen this in many people that once we eradicate candida, we get the numbers down, they can actually eat gluten again, right? So gluten doesn't have to be gluten-free. It doesn't have to be like, you know, a maxi security life sentence at all. Just because your healthcare professional tells you you need to avoid gluten, it does not mean you have to avoid gluten for all of your life. There are some conditions like psoriasis, for example, that I work a lot in, which is autoimmune. We found that up to 65% of psoriatic patients, in fact, have got candida. Now, I can tell you now from my experience, when you eradicate candida in these patients, they can tolerate gluten again. It's absolutely true. I've seen this in the clinic numerous times. So you don't all have to jump on the gluten-free bandwagon, okay? There are reasons why people become gluten intolerant. But nobody looks at the reasons. They just said, oh yeah, I'm going gluten-free. I'm not eating this. I've got gluten-free toilet paper. I got gluten-free lipstick. I drive a gluten-free car. You know, everything's gluten-free today. But folks, what I'm saying is look into it. Why people become intolerant to a particular food or substance? Is it because they're drinking maybe too much alcohol? Is it because they're not sleeping enough? Have they got a high stress lifestyle? What's undermining their system to, you know, decrease the tolerability of gluten? Have they got HWP1 protein? You know, what's going on in their digestive system? With a bit of investigation and insight into the GI tract, often these problems can be solved. So just remember there's a link between gluten and candida. Thanks for tuning in. Grab my report in the description box, my candida report, if you haven't already got it, and check out the links that are put down on that particular candida protein for further perusal. Thanks for tuning in, guys.